More than 1,000 yards of offense, 80 points. It lived up to the hype. The Saints win their seventh in a row, knocking off the last unbeaten team. Anybody up here think we just saw a preview of the NFC Championship?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
How about this win by the Saints?
Huge. Huge ramifications of the game. And you know, Sean Payton and Drew Brees had heard about enough of Sean McVay and Jared Goff, two dynamic offenses. The Saints ended up really being the difference in terms of controlling the clock a little bit more, 6-7 minutes. It was one of those games where you can't make a mistake. You have to hold serve, and the Saints did it more often.
You know what, Tony Gonzalez? You take a look at this NFC South today. Atlanta's third straight win. Carolina's third straight win. And now New Orleans has won 7 in a row.
Yeah. Like I said before, I think it's the best division in all of football right now. But I'll talk a little bit about the Carolina Panthers. That team right there is trending upwards right now. Norv Turner has those guys running great offense. It's trick plays. It's not just one guy doing it. It's all of them doing it. And obviously it starts with Cam Newton, 6'5", 265 pounds, running 5 yards a carry. It's impossible to stop right now.
So not only do the Saints get the win, scoring 45 points today, Michael Thomas had the biggest receiving day of any player in the league this year, even with the homage to Joe Horn afterwards. I'm sure it would be a little different story had they wound up losing the football game. He was a big part of them winning. You were actually on the other side when Joe Horn did that back in 2003 against the Giants.
I was there. I didn't like it then. I didn't like it now. But, you know, I think guys want to be creative. They want to come up and have, you know, something that's different from what everybody else is doing. That I don't like when you do the prop, because it's also a manner of respect if you score a touchdown and go up.
What if they score quick?
Well, I didn't like that.
They turn around and score quick.
And what if you lose the game? You look like a fool, and it kind of overshadows such a big game that this kid has. So hopefully it's a one-time thing.
Yeah, you know, I said in the pregame show, and I believe it really did make sense, that they've already beaten Minnesota. They'd already beaten Washington. This is a football team that had beaten Baltimore. The Saints learned how to play good defense in close games on the road and dismantling a good Washington team at home. Today, I thought they played flawless. I thought they played with a lot of reserve. And you know what? Quite honestly, they played with confidence. And the confidence they get from this game forward is huge.
Yeah, and especially on the defensive side of the ball, because I think that's probably been the biggest knock of them. It's obviously not offense with Drew Brees. If they made stops when they had to, especially at the end of the game. And like I said, I played in that NFC South for 5 years. It is so tough to go in there and win a game. If they get that home field advantage, watch out. Watch out, because they're a really good football team.
Howie, the focus was on New Orleans. You take a look at the numbers from Drew Brees. 4 touchdown passes, no interceptions again, and he wasn't sacked.
Yeah, and we talked about it in the pregame. If they could protect, particularly the interior three, Pete Unger and Warford, they did an outstanding job. There were plays to be made down the field. 0 sacks today for the Rams. Extraordinary number. Really extraordinary number.
For more on the Saints, let's get it over to Jay Glazer. Jay?
All right. Hey, Kurt, you guys were just talking about the Michael Thomas with the cell phone. Sean Payton told me all week long he has been hammering into his team, we've got to learn how to handle prosperity, not adversity, but prosperity. And you know he's going to continue to hammer it all week long this coming week as well. Hey, let's take you around the league now. Injury-wise, wasn't too bad today. The only couple here, Denzel Ward, potential defensive rookie of the year. He went down with a hip injury. They're going to give him further tests tomorrow. They're hoping that he escaped with serious injury. Also, Calvin Ridley for those streaking Atlanta Falcons went down with a head injury, but the Falcons tell me they think he'll be okay for next week. Look, Pittsburgh Steelers, they beat the Browns 2 weeks ago. Hugh Jackson was out, beat the Ravens today, and now John Harbaugh. He has to field questions about his job security. Talk about the Steelers. We have them on Thursday Night Football, which means, of course, more Le'Veon Bell questions. He's not going to play this week, and if he doesn't show up by next Tuesday, he cannot play at all this year. Kurt?
Well, if James Conner keeps playing like he does, nobody will care. Who won the day, guys? Start with you, Tony.
I'm going to go with the Atlanta Falcons. I think for them to go into Washington, the defense held them to 14 points. That's outstanding. And then offensively, everything. I mean, Matt Ryan is playing well. Julio Jones got his first touchdown. Tevin Coleman was like a piece of bacon. It goes with everything. He's doing everything in that offense that they asked him to do. So
I love it.
It was just a great day.
Piece of bacon. Pork.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, goes, bacon goes with everything. Okay. I hope you know
this
that.
This dude, ice cream. You and these puns. Okay, I'm going to put my bacon on the New Orleans Saints. I mean, we've talked about it since the game has been over. These guys have been outstanding. Michael Thomas, great game, especially for such a young player. Drew Brees, consistent, and the defense stepped up. And it's just a matter of can you keep up with their scoring? The Rams couldn't do it, and if they can't, I don't know who can.
Vikings franchise record, 10 sacks on the road in Detroit. Danielle Hunter, 3.5 sacks, giving him 11.5 on the year. Outstanding.
And a touchdown.
and a touchdown.
And James Conner, the running back for the Steelers, who, by the way, you're right, Jay, Thursday night, we've got a great one. We've got Carolina and the Pittsburgh Steelers and James Conner, who right now has 10 touchdowns on the year. By the way, that is a record for the Steelers most since 1950.
You were getting that stat out one way or another, weren't you?
That's the only stat I've used all day.
We will see right, you Thursday night football. It should be a good one.
See you there.
See you next week, folks.